Heavenly Father, creator of all things in heaven and on earth, I give you thanks for this beautiful day you've created for this meeting. I ask you to bless the members of this court. I give you thanks for all the participants, and I ask for your protective hand to be over all of them, and that you would bless each of them for the sacrifices they are making today. As the business of running the county is addressed, I pray that you would shine your light of righteousness and cover in the power of your love all of us here in your presence. Holy Spirit, we ask that you would minister to our spirits at this very moment. Open our eyes to your mercy and your grace. Place in our hearts and minds the people in Wilson County that work so hard to improve the quality of life for all of those who live, teach, learn, protect, build, serve, or will serve the county in some form or fashion. Ensure that they are all remembered and cared for. Guide and protect our county's law enforcement officers and first responders in harm's way this day and in the future. Bless our homes, our families, our finances, and our involvement in this glorious county. And may we bring honor and glory to you, Father, in all we do and say. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Amen. May the Lord Jesus to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Under the Texas flag, I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
Is there anything highlighted at the bottom?
What's that?
Is there anything highlighted at the bottom? highlighted. We've got the presenter.
Does he have a title on the card?
But there's no, that I can find, no name on here.
Yes, that would be fine.
What's that? This is yours? Okay. Your Nikki Storwell. Okay, and then certificate of achievement certified that Lisa McCall has completed the course getting started with social media for your library, September 11, 2018, presented by Amy Hitchner and Jessica Bacon, 1 hour. Certificate of achievement certified that Lisa McCall has completed the course grace under pressure tips and tricks to cultivate a positive approach, September 10, 2018, 1.5 hours, presentation by Cheryl Haywood, Georgia Bomax, and Anna Shelton. It's to certify certificate of achievement certified by Lisa McCall has completed the course Instagram for public libraries, good practices for social media, September 10, 2018, 1 hour, techsoup.org. Edweb.net, certificate of completion, PBL and assessment, how do you measure learning in PBL, presented by Lisa Mayer, director of STEAM, Fairmont School of New York, October 17, 2018, Sherry Mangini, 1 hour. Texas State Library Workhouse Commission Certificate of Course Completion is certified by Vicki Myrick has completed the course engaged in teens in your library for 6.5 credit hours, February 26, 2018. Texas Library Workhouse Commission.
I
which employers are we talking about? Are we going to just address anybody in particular? Because we have addressed some of them, and we've got a new fiscal year just started.
Yeah, and that's why it's important to bring it up now.
Oh, okay. I thought we had a particular one.
No, okay. Let's prepare for this year. Let's make sure it will happen this year that we refer to this new fiscal year.
Well, hopefully, one thing, I think, where our elections, we won't have elections this year, so that'll
solve all my problems. But it just is a matter of us coming in compliance with law.
Yeah.
You know, we have been doing things out of compliance for a long time. Now we have a professional HR lady here that's informing us of what we need to do better to be in compliance and not put ourselves in a financial position behind. When I understand that a budget can't be amended for a department overall, unless it's an emergency, is that correct?
On something, yes. An emergency is something that cannot be anticipated.
Right. And amending the department budget to cover excessive overtime being an emergency.
I think it's important that, maybe we do communicate again, because my last recollection was that a part-time person can work in excess of 29 hours a week.
That's correct.
And if they pass that threshold and we don't provide them with insurance, then federally we have a problem. And it may be something that needs to be just readdressed, just letting everyone know for a memo or whatever that if you have part-time people, they cannot see 29 hours a week.
And wait a minute, we just have to create a force for the department head. That's the policy. We can't deviate from that policy. Adding that to them?
You're right. And even if they do work over 29 hours a week, that's something that you have to adjust, say, the week after. The magic number is 1,560 in a 12-month time period. Yeah. So as long as you don't go through that.
They sign their timesheets, don't they?
Yes,
they do. So the supervisor has to know.
Absolutely.
Because they sign their contract.
And that's why I think it's important that we communicate with the department heads. They forgot, they don't know, or there's some issues, all of this.
Well, and I guess the other end of that, 1,500 how many hours?
1,560.
Is that the problem? That I can see is that if I were using, I'll speak to me, a part-time person, and on occasion I was working more hours, and other occasions I was not, we're probably maybe through HR, I'm not sure. Most department heads, including myself, might not do a good job keeping track of those hours. If they're working 29 hours a week, then you know where you are. And when I have a partner, I never look to see 29 hours a week. But it may be on a quarterly basis that we may need to send some sort of report to these departments, just letting them know how many hours there should be within a quarter of a year for your personnel. And you can pretty well prevent that. I don't know how difficult that would be.
It's not. I have a spreadsheet set up right now on my computer, so I can personally
because there may be some department heads that are just literally not paying attention, but there may be others where it happens in caution if I wouldn't have heard that. So I think upon a quarterly basis, we may make folks aware and we can eliminate that problem. And I guess if we have a situation that is potentially going to be one that's going to require someone moving into all the benefits associated with it, then that has to be brought to them attention in advance and figure out what are we going to do. We're going to figure out whether we make this person full time or are we just going to say, sorry, Larry, but I can't work you anymore until the end of this period.
Well, I think management training would help, especially time management training. A lot of department heads haven't had any formal training
what y'all are talking about, it's the elections administrator, the elections office. Because this, we had an election here this year, and that is the reason. This is what happened. Okay, we've approached.
I have a disagreement. Okay, but at the time, it was used throughout the year.
In which, what are we talking about? We're not talking about elections.
No, in the elections office.
Okay. And how do you disagree with me? It's not elections then.
One thing I'll say, I disagree that it happened to be because of the election year. The time was used up at a time when there was elections going on. And then the individual working 40 hours or 38 hours instead of 29, the time is more necessary.
Okay, I mean, I don't know, and maybe you know more about their office than I do, if it was necessary or not, but I do know, yes, these people were putting those hours in, and we have approached what this is. Like I said, you may know more about what's going on in the office, but I know if they have been working, they've been working all year for the election. There's things that they do that not necessarily has to do with the elections, to get prepared for the election, things like that. And I'm not taking up for them, but I'm explaining to you what has happened and that we have been approaching this the last week, trying to get it.
It seemed to me then that we need to somehow take that into consideration every other time, every other year, essentially, every 2 years when we have elections.
And we've approached that also. We've been working on this because next year the next year is going to be a big election, and we're going to have to have a lot bigger budget. We're going to have to prepare for a lot more things that are going to happen. We're going to have to maybe prepare for having early voting in two different places in the county instead of just one.
Which tells me that possibly the elections office needs to hire more full-time people.
And that's what we're approaching. That's what we're approaching also. We're looking into this. It's not like we've been sitting there pulling our thumbs. We're getting prepared for what's going to come in 2020. This year, there's going to be it's going to be a small election that happened. I don't know if anybody's going to petition for anything to happen. But if not, this will be a good slack year, but 2020 is going to be a real ambitious year, I guess you can call it, but it's going to have lots of, we're going to have to prepare for it.
We have a lot of things turned out 2 years ago, they turned out this year. What I'm saying is, again, our population is growing, and all I'm saying is maybe we should determine if that department needs to grow. I know it's not getting any less busy with the population growing like it is, so we need to hire more people.
And that's what we're looking at.
Yeah, so that's a kind of study we need to do, or research to see what we need to do to address this without.
Well, we know what we've had, and we're kind of predicting what we think we're going to have. There's no way to know for sure.
Behind the scenes work that goes into doing it. So I'm just speaking on behalf of Olga that we were small.
They were overwhelmed.
You saw.
They were overwhelmed, and that's something that we need to address, and you're right, the issue is not, I think finding full-time people probably isn't going to be a problem, but finding part-time people that you can rely on and get the numbers in, because we need more numbers for those short periods of time, that may be difficult.
And it's more complex than just.
Oh, yes. And if we thought the election 2 years ago was a big deal, then this one was a big deal, just wait till the next one.
Now, under the status of the jail, the election administration office, there's a board that sits on all that, right?
Yes.
They make decisions on what basis?
Well, it's the elections commission, I guess you could call it, consists of myself, Eva, tax collector, and both chairmen of the chairman of each party.
Yes, do that.
What decision do the board make?
Yes.
I mean, are they determining any more people? Do they make that decision?
And actually, that would be August part. We determine what happens if they all go. Okay, she's hired by the elections commission. Okay, she's hired to do the job of the elections administrator. And here's the deal, if she's split, okay, because she has to come to the commission for a part of our people because we're the ones in favor. But we can make suggestions to her, Eva, or excuse me, Olga, you need to do this, you need to do that. But when it comes time to the hiring, she's got to come here because we're the ones in favor of the people that work for her.
Through the budget process.
Through the budget process.
I think that's all we need, just to learn out how much it's really going to cost and see who can hire people ahead of time. Before it gets out of hand.
Well, elections are going to continue to grow and get people more complex because of the atmosphere and environment we're in today. Everybody's getting involved now before they did.
But the problem is hiring people.
Yeah.
It's just like the polling places, they're having difficult times hiring people for churches and all that. That's the whole issue right now.
And I agree with the thought that you expressed, Judge. Assuming we can staff it, it would make sense to have two polling places.
Yes, and this is the thing that was discussed on the body of government. We may have to raise what we pay the election judges and election workers to entice somebody to come to work for us. Because it's going to be 2 weeks of non-stop, work, and then all of a sudden, you're through.
Has it been affected since the only other election, like the school and city, create more hours and more work?
I had to go work two polling places this year, the primaries, and I had to go work Stockdale because it's hard to get people to work elections. And that, Olga then had to be on the election side. That left Rosalinda, the only one answering the phones. And I'm telling you, when I got ready in the evening, it was already over, but just going and listening to messages. Normally we have two people that can answer the phone. But of course it's election, and this was the first year too. I don't get to see it. Election day, we stress to people, you have to go to your polling location. A lot of them don't realize they still come, thinking we could be early voting there, it's going on there. Well then we had, like I said, I didn't see it. They said they had people lined up election day, thinking they vote there, not realizing they have to go into their precinct. Like I said, we were just, everyone, overwhelmed, short-staffed.
Okay, we've got a few months to work on that.
I just thought it was a good point to bring up and for us to discuss. We can do whatever research and take care of the tax necessary to address the problem. Keep us in compliance.
Okay, so I am on the budget. The election administrator did give me an itemized list of what she was anticipating on spending. So we had not exceeded this year's budget. That's how the budget was based on kind of what you guys gave me when I built your budget. So I can only go off of what the department head gives us.
Exactly.
Okay, agenda item number seven, our skip high, 2023, discuss and take action on purchase of water truck precinct.
That water truck, I have a valve, did one of the water trucks, it was the first one. It's beyond repair, it's outdated. The pool's left, we put the brake on, and the oil fixed that.
And a little bit of water.
Still goes bad, it still goes bad. That's the problem, so, I've got a 2014, water truck that's also ready to go. And so we need this, we need water truck to do the roads, and the one we have now, it says, hey, we want to drive it now. So I just want to bring it.
You're gonna buy that, correct?
Yes.
Okay, it's under 50, so it's.
Yeah.
And who is it, don't have any money?
Bylor, or?
No, you can't go with Bylor, so.
That'll be Jay, I think that has that one.
Since it's under 50, you don't want to.
Right.
It's a use.
What's that?
It's a use, you can go to Bylor.
Oh, it's used?
Yeah.
Okay, 50, so we don't have to do it now.
Well, we're gonna check it out, Mike, we'll get all the truck. We'll check it, it's something that we definitely, so.
Maybe you know the rest of the commissioners can go to bar.
They haven't come, got the turd yet.
You're.
And it's how much?
$4,900. Just make a motion, we allow the bylaws to run.
I'll say it.
Motion by Commissioner Hyatt, second by Commissioner Wiley, purchase of water truck precinct three. Is there any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Passes. Okay, agenda item number eight, our comments, Commissioner Precinct One, discuss and take action on the Con Jubilee Day proclamation. We have a shelter house in San Antonio, Florida, that's gonna bring the proclamation for us.
Thank you. Good morning, my name is Chelsea Giles, I'm the intergovernmental coordinator for the Commission for Liberty. Like, thank Judge Jackson and the Commissioner's Court for having me here this morning, really appreciate the opportunity. The River of Liberty is very excited for this Saturday, as the annual Con Jubilee Desert Bake Off event in Halton Nature Park, a broad event flyer, something we would like to want. But I'm also excited to present this proclamation for the event. A proclamation of the Wilson County Commissioner's Court proclaiming the third Saturday of November as the San Antonio River Authority's Con Jubilee Day, held annually at the John William Halton San Antonio River Nature Park in Wilson County, Texas. Whereas, the San Antonio River Authority operates and manages John William Halton San Antonio River Nature Park in Wilson County, and provides events